Where we at? Where we at? What's happening? All right, looks like it's going. What's happening, everybody? Welcome, 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 everybody. Welcome to the Mobile Salon sponsored Mr. Hair Art Show. I'm your host, Ronnie Mac. You guys know me as Mr. Hair Art and Coach. And we're live. We're live, everybody. We're live, live, live. What's happening? All right. Hey, Jason, what's up? Okay, guys, we are live broadcasting. Let me get my setup done here on multiple different channels, multiple different platforms, all at the same time. We are broadcasting on Instagram, on Facebook, on YouTube, on Twitter, on Twitch, on LinkedIn, on Discord, on our websites at mobilon.com, at Facebook, at HHH Charity. .org on our, that's our charity website, and then on our television channel website for Hair Art TV. So you can watch us live every day at 6 o'clock on any of those platforms under Mr. Hair Art. That is me. All right, guys, I'm checking on my screens over here, making sure that they're live and they're actually broadcasting. We are broadcasting in the Mobile Salon buses as well. I had some complaints from some people that was that are in the buses that was saying that the signal was not clear in the buses. So what I'm going to say is there is if you don't have your signal all the way, all of the bars across and everything lined up, it will degrade the signal throughout the entire bus. So you have to either reset the modem, because all of the buses have a wireless hotspot or a mobile hotspot, so the internet is always on wherever you go, because that's how we check our security cameras. But you have to reset it if it doesn't give you the bars all the way across, because what happens is There's two signals on every bus. There's a signal for, hey, Taylor Ford, what's happening? Taylor says, hey, Coach, how's the team in the business? Super good. I ain't seen you in a while. Where you been? What's happening? What's going on with you? Hey, Jason, what's up? Well, welcome into the stream. I see Miss Spearman. Felicia, is that you? I think that's Kenfolk over there. Hey, Felicia, I see AJ Black. Black is beautiful. What's happening? Welcome to the stream. Thank y'all all for coming through and rolling with us. Crazy 8. What's up, Crazy 8? I ain't seen you. Well, I think I seen you, about last month? Yeah, I think I saw you last month. What's happening? How's everything? I hope everything is good with you. Welcome in, everybody. Thank y'all for coming through. Let's see. Hold on. I'm trying to get the stream on here because I got the different signals, but they get mixed up. Taylor, what'd you say? I like actually funny on the store. On which store are you talking about your store or the salon fundraiser? What you got going on over there? Let me know. And oh, the buses. There's two signals. One is for the security cameras and the security system. That's a hardwired system that can't be changed. It just automatically uploads, because that's how we watch the buses and make sure everybody's safe. So that can't be changed. But the internal signal, where you guys can get online, where you're watching watching TV or movies or whatnot inside the buses, that's a fluctuating or a alternating signal. So the username, password, and all that stuff changes. Depending on what signal it's actually broadcasting. So it basically searches for the best signal to use, or the best signal strength, so that whoever's on the bus can actually use it. So if it's blurry or if it doesn't come through, you have to reset and it'll alternate. It'll basically search for a better signal. It'll search for a stronger signal strength. And then it'll do all that automatically. Just all you have to do is press the reset button on the inside of the cabinet. All the buses have a cabinet. Press that reset button, and it'll search for a better signal. It always does that. But if you turn it on and it's just on, it's using the last programmed or last found signal, and that signal may be weak. Okay, so just kind of keep that in mind. The signal may be weak, so it won't you're gonna want to find a stronger signal. So just reset it, and it'll search for a stronger signal. Taylor, you said the fundraiser. Yeah, the fund. Do you have your fundraiser? Do you have your links and everything set up, making sure that people can get to it? Because the links, I mean, all of the pages and the campaigns are all individually set. So whenever y'all get funds coming in, it'll show up on that page. It'll actually show up. So, and it's going to be easier these next couple of, literally in, what? This is April? Yeah, May is coming up, guys. It's going to be crazy. So this is the month that everybody is trying to get everything kind of put together before May hits, because May is when we're kind of announcing the program and the project that we had. We had a soft launch in January. Now we're going to have a preliminary launch, or basically the launch of the program and everything, in May, which is coming up next month. So we were going to do a grand opening in May, on May 10th, my birthday, but a lot of people are not ready. They don't have their artwork and everything turned in, and they wanted more time to kind of put it together. So we pushed that back to July. But we're still doing the presentation. We're doing all of the proposals and the setups, the seminars, the campaign launches. We're doing all the commercials. All that stuff is happening next month for this program, for what we are doing right now, mobile salons. All of that stuff is happening next month. So and I found out that we're going to be launching this this live. So this live will be going live throughout our whole platform, because we right now we are out there to the point to where people who are in the know will follow, you know, fall on us or jump on that's fine. But when we advertise, when we actually put it out there for people to see it, that's when everybody else will get wind of what we got going on, and then it turns into a madhouse. I can tell y'all that right now, because we've done it twice before. And this time we're going to be ready for it. This time we're going to be, last time we did a app launch where we launched the mobile salon app, and we got slaughtered. We got hit real hard, and we were not ready for it at all. And then we ended up having to pull the app down off the App Store, off of Google Play, and all that. We had to pull everything down. Because we had way too many people, and we couldn't deal with everybody coming through. But now, hold on, I'll turn it on. I got an overlay. I don't have my earpiece in, so I don't know. Hold on, because I got it right here, and I know I can put it in. Taylor said what? Okay, there's money. Cuss on the. You say okay? There's the money. Cuts on the hair design clippers. The hair clippers aren't on, or the hair design clippers. Well, mine are not on there because mine are not here yet. My moderators want me to put my earpiece in because they're giving me instructions, but I can't hear them. So I got to put my. I'll either have headphones on and I can hear them, or I have the earbuds in. The earbuds are easier. And it taps right in, and I can hear. There we go. Okay. It said it had to connect, and now I can hear everybody talking. Why is everybody talking at once? I can't hear y'all. We're going to have to take turns or something. So one at a time, I don't care who, just whoever's going to do it. And if y'all can get together offline, then, you know, come back online, let me know what's popping and what's happening. Yeah, we're going to try to, I don't know if we're going to move around because I wanted to go out and show you the new bus. We got a new bus that we have coming, And we have a new supplier for our starter buses. Okay, so everybody right now, and it's going to go really fast, so I hope y'all are ready. I told y'all, once y'all get past chapter five is our midpoint for the school. Once you get past chapter five, everything it goes really, really quick, because it's all everything from that point is about how do you drive, learning how, making sure you know how to use the mirrors and the backup cameras, and learning how to park, parallel park in a bus and all that. Because parallel parking a bus is way different from parallel parking a car. Okay. And most of the parking you're going to be doing is parallel parking, because if you're going to an event, or you're going to a concert or to the park or anything like that, you're going to be pulling up and pulling up into a spot. So most of the time you're having to parallel park, which is drive up and then back in and pull back. And these are large, units. These are not small. These are large units that if you get it wrong, you can tap somebody real easy. Okay. So it is very, very vital that everybody knows how to drive. But the new supplier actually will be supplying us the buses. So it's kind of a double-edged sword, if you will. What's up, Phil? I see Phil popped in. What's up, Darnese? Darnell is in the house. Hey, what's happening? I see Jason. Jay, I already seen you. I said, what's up to Jason? Jason said, what's up, what's up, what's up? He put what's up. I said, what's up to you, Jay? I see Miss Peaches in the house. What's happening, Miss Peaches? Welcome to the stream. I see you. My live is on. I think I see the live on Instagram. I'm looking at it. I'm on live on Instagram, and I'm looking at my live on the website on mobilon.com. I'm looking at it right now. So whoever said that, y'all might want to refresh your page. Whoever looking at it. What's up, Phil? Hey, Phil. I got your boy Craig Dunn, and I submitted it yesterday, but yesterday was Sunday, so they don't work on the weekends, but it should be in today. If it's not in, if he doesn't have it, let me know. And then I'll look into it directly. And then also I checked with Loma, but Loma told me earlier to make sure that you were good on your end, because it's tax time. And I was not aware of that. And especially today, it's April 15th. So this is the last day. And she is extremely big. She does taxes for people and for companies. So they're hitting her real hard to get all of the taxes and stuff done. And people are filing extensions and all that type of stuff. So she does all of that. So she does taxes for a lot of people and a lot of companies. So she's been working on that. But I went in there Saturday night. What's Saturday? 2 days ago? Yeah, today's Monday. So Saturday. And she was actually working, doing research on the South Africa deal. So she's blending our stuff in with her stuff. So that was pretty cool. But yeah, she told me to make sure that you're aware that that's what's going on with that stuff. And hopefully everything is still smooth. And there was something else. I don't have my notes here, guys, so I don't know all of my points. So I'm just kind of winging it and answering questions. If y'all have questions, okay, I got it. I'm clicking it now. Okay, if y'all have questions, comments, suggestions, or just have information you'd like to share, throw it into the chat. Yeah, I don't think the overlay is working. See, I click the overlay right now. Hold on. Guys, look at this. Well. Hold up. Normally, I don't put the chat overlay on because it was not working. And I got I sent messages out to Restream, but normally I just talk through the through my stream, and I know there's somebody up there watching and listening, and now it looks like they have it working, because I just clicked on overlay and I did not have anything on beforehand. And normally when you click it on, it doesn't be working. But one of my moderators just said, turn on chat overlay. And I was like, no, I'm not turning on chat overlay because it's not going to show anything. Every time I turn it off and turn it back on, it's going to delete all the chats. And then if I go switch to something else, which is what we're going to do right now, we're going to switch to something else and then come back, it's going to delete all the chats. But now it looks like they're in. And they wasn't, it didn't make us start over. It picked up all the chats that were in there. So we're about to see if it keeps all the chats in. We're going to go to a commercial, then come back and see if the chats are still in. Okay, Phil, I got you. Phil said it's all good. I'll get her the message. But yeah, we still own it. We ain't going to let up off of it, dog. We got to have that. Phil, if y'all see Old School Mobile Barber, that's Philip Kiley. That's one of our partners. And he's going to be headed to South Africa. And we're going to be opening up Mobile Salon in South Africa, guys. Y'all not only will have the ability to franchise in South Africa, meaning have buses rolling out in South Africa. You got to have your money. You got to have your money ready. But you'll be able to franchise South Africa. And when we're talking about being able to travel and feel. I talked to my partners, the other guys, just like I was talking to you. I'm talking to my guy in Dubai, my guy in the UK, my guy in Japan. I just talked to somebody in Tokyo, but I don't know. There was a real big language barrier with him. So I don't know how that's going to work. But everybody is wanting to set up. Oh, Canada, Australia. You know, I got several people that are wanting to set up a sister company or basically a franchise link. It's a company that is an extension of Mobile Salon. So in that company, you would have your own company or your own business. And then we would link up with you and then we would coordinate and be able to build buses together. So setting up the curriculum, setting up the networking, the contracting, the advertising space, the whole nine yards, getting money through contractors, getting money through corporate entities, all that type of stuff. Is what we do with our franchisees and our companies that are setting up in other countries. Now, the funny thing and quite possibly one of the most awesome things is there's a possibility that we would be setting up I guess you would call it, because we don't have a name for it, but it's like a travel extension sort of partnership, you know, camaraderie type thing. It is quite literally, if we have somebody there in that country, then we now have a link in that country. And when you travel there physically, when you actually get tickets and get on the plane or boat or whatever, and you literally go to that country, then we have someone who can receive you, okay? And they know the area, they know the country, they know the layout. They can basically set you up with hotels and rides and accommodations and everything, whether you're paying for them, which will be the normal way, or it's sponsored, where if you're good, you know, because we work off sponsorship over here. But if you're good, you could do a sponsored trip where the company will pay you to go to other countries and actually get into a Mobile Salon bus that is already set up in that country. And you'll be able to work there for however long you're going to be staying in that country. And it's basically like a work visa / vacation trip, because there's no better way to learn the culture and to immerse yourself into a new country and a new language and a new people than to do hair, than to literally do their hair. The hair is the same, but the people are different. Okay, hair is the same all over the world, but people are different. So it's a whole thing about, I don't like to travel, and I don't want to go places where I don't know anybody. And I don't have a hookup. Most of the time, people will find travel agents. You know what I mean? People that, it's sort of like a guide that when you come to a different land, somebody or a company will assign you somebody, or they'll they'll kind of point you in the right direction of where you want to go. Where's the best places to go eat? Where's places that has good venues or good events that's going on? Tickets to here or there or whatever. They know all of that stuff because they're in that culture. They're there. It's just like if somebody came to your town or your city or your state or your country, which is here in America. If somebody came to Texas and they say, hey, coach, I'm coming out here and I don't know the place. I've never been here before. Whether they're coming from out of state or out of the country, if they're coming from the UK, coming here, which I've done multiple times with family and associates and business people, they're coming from out of the country and they come here and we know the best hotels. We have connections and stuff with events and locations where they can go and basically spend time when we're not doing business. We have all of that stuff hooked up because we live here. You know, we've been here all, you know, pretty much all our life. But the whole scenario is we have a platform that's never been done before, not to my knowledge, and I've been looking. We have a platform where you're working in your industry, where you're working in your industry, and you're able to basically book and travel to another country, another location, even that small, something as small as another state, and someone will receive you and have a bus ready for you to work on. That's freaking awesome. That's the best thing ever. So, because you're not going to drive your bus across state lines all the way across, you know, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 states, you know, just to go somewhere and be there for a couple of weeks and you don't have any income or nothing to do, or you want to be able to do something. It's like, we've been doing this conversation for the last couple of days, and we've been mulling over logistics, legalities, terms and conditions, what all would be necessary and what's needed, and how can this sell? And man, I mean, my guys love it because it doesn't exist in our industry at all, even though hair is everywhere. You can literally, and I'm gonna take the most extreme example. I know I'm going off on this, but I get excited when we're putting something together that's groundbreaking, has never been done before, and that we are able to deploy and give to our industry of barbers and stylists, okay? It's something that's never been done before. Take, and I'll give you an extreme example. Take a black person, okay, that's gonna travel all the way to Tokyo, okay, or Japan, where there's hardly any black people at all. There's hardly any, the culture divide is extreme. But you know how to do their hair. You know how to cut straight hair. You know how to cut Asian hair. You know how to style it. You know what you're doing, okay? That presents you a very unique opportunity to travel over there, whether you're paying or your sponsor and a company is paying for your track. Because we set all of that up. We actually put all of that in place, okay? A company is paying for you to travel over there and promote and do different things as well as do hair over in that land. That is a beautiful, beautiful scenario and opportunity for you to be able to travel, number one, but be able to enjoy another culture, another land, another country, and still be safe. Still be safe. That's key. That's key, because y'all already know, traveling, especially going overseas or going to different lands and whatnot, it can get iffy. It can get real iffy real fast. What old school say? Sounds great. Let's see. Sounds great. Yes, the 90 days on the passport and the visa. Okay, that's for Loma. Then say, like, work study for barbers. Exactly. That's exactly correct, Phil. We're trying to get a program that's never existed before that's going to harness our power as barbers and stylists in our industry, because the barbers and the stylists of our industry, we know everything. When you go to a barber or a stylist in an area and you want to know, hey, where's the best such and such as this or that, they're going to know. When they know where the best food is, they know where the best plays, where the best movies, what's the best, you know, they know where to go to get the good stuff. Okay, barbers and stuff. And they're everywhere. There's barbershops and beauty salons everywhere. So like I said, I got connection. We're literally setting up right now. Right now, we're setting up Dubai. We're setting up UK. Phil, who's on here right now, is setting up South Africa. Imagine being able to go to South Africa, the motherland, where we're from, being able to go to South Africa. And Phil receives you because he knows the people, he knows the connection, he got connection with the land, where to go and where not to go. Where to go and where not to go. See, all of that plays a part in what we do, because the barbers and the stylists in these lands, they know all of this stuff. They know, don't go in that part of town. But if you go over here, you're good. You know, and we're in Mobile Salon. So there, people are gonna naturally kind of respect us anyway, because we're a industry for the people. So barbers and stylists are kind of, they're genuinely on the largest percentage, and it's like, if somebody tells you they're a barber, or if somebody tells you they're a stylist, a regular person, people in the world, they'll immediately bring you in. They'll immediately make you a part of. Oh, okay. What kind of hair do you do? Oh, you do. You can I get a business card? They immediately accept you because you help people. We help people. That's what we do. So we're genuinely not combative people. We're genuinely not people that you're gonna have a problem with. So people accept us in all the time. So that's our priority. The best phase? Is that double phase? Oh, like W phase. Okay, I would love to cut hair in Japan. Yeah. Most definitely, and that's the whole thing. It's not just Japan, double face. It's anywhere, because there's hair anywhere. There's people everywhere. Hey, is that Sade Beauty, Beauty Bar? What's happening? Welcome into the stream. What's happening? Y'all in these names. That's Crazy A. What's up, Crazy A? Crazy A said, man, I want to cut hair in, I don't even know where that is. Myanmar? Where's Myanmar? Unless that's like the other area from Morocco. So you must know something about that already. But that's the whole point. There are barbershops and beauty salons everywhere, because there's hair everywhere. And with us building this platform and building this program like we're building it, it's like having... Like my boy say, being studying abroad, being an exchange student. Imagine if we did something like that, where you're exchanging buses. You go and you're going to be working their bus and their clientele for a week, and they're coming and they're going to exchange and work your clientele. That would be, number one, a logistical nightmare, but people sign off on that stuff. People literally say, okay, so you're such and such, you're Brenda's exchange person. Okay, so do you know how to do this type of, are you good? Okay, well, we're gonna try you out. There are people who will be adventuresome and try people out. And then there are clients who will say, no, I'm gonna wait till my regular barber get back. I'm gonna wait till my stylist get back. I ain't gonna be having people playing in my head. It's all types of people, all types of stuff. So I'm just excited about the possibilities and what we're potentially setting up right now. Nothing set in stone, but it is moving forward. I mean, it's every time I talk to somebody who's overseas and has it, they immediately jump on it, because number one, it's a huge money maker. You can make a lot of money off of it. But it's fun. It literally just sounds fun to be able to have people coming in and out and being able to exchange goods and services from people from other lands. So that's an awesome thing. Okay. Oh, let me do this and check my text before I mess around and forget. Guys, we're gonna go to commercial. We're gonna go to commercial, and I'm gonna do a little rigmarole over here just to check my text, because this is pretty important to me that this works, because I want to be able to leave text on all the time and not have to worry about it blinking out or doing something crazy. So the text that is over on this side right here, this is the text, It only has, I think, YouTube and Facebook and a couple of channels. It doesn't have all of the text linked in yet, but if it works, I'm going to go ahead and pay to have them link all of the texts in that we get, that I get, that I can see on my screen. I'm going to have them link them all in and then just advise everybody, hey, everybody can see everything. Okay, so if you're putting text in there, it doesn't just come to me anymore. It goes out and everybody can see it. So mind your manners and be conscious of that, that everybody can see it. But let's go to commercial real quick. It's going to be a quick little break, and then we're going to see what happens to the text when we come back. If it's still on, guys, we may have us a winner here. I'm going to put a little brief little something on here and then come back through. So you guys hold what you got and let's see what's popping.
MrHairArt Network is finally introducing the tools that are used to create those wild and awesome barber etchings and hair art designs. The new MrHairArt Stencil Kit. Go to www.MrHairArt.com to purchase your very own hair art stencil kit. Mr. Ronnie Mac, also known as Mr. Hair Art, has created this product just for you. Inside this kit, you'll find the tools you need to create your own fabulous works of hair art. From the clear, durable stencils to the color pencils and hair art spray, everything you'll need to make more money, easier and faster, whether you're amateur or professional.
To order this hair art stencil kit or any of our hair art products, call 1-800-406-7711 or you can order online at www.MrHairArt.com.
Order now and get in on the new, more profitable world of hair art.
All right, we're back. Okay, guys, it's still up there. I ain't gonna count my chicken for the hash, but it's still up there. Hold on, let me turn it off. Turn it back on. Yeah, it's still going. Man, yeah, we may have ourselves a winner. Restream. If you guys fix this, y'all did a great, great thing, because the overlay is still on and it's not cutting off, and y'all doing a great thing. And I pay enough money for the doggone thing to work. But this company, I do recommend it. Restream, if you guys are trying to broadcast multiple channels at the same time. This company, I've been with them for a long time. I've been with them for many, many years. And I just stuck with them because they had a good platform and a good service, and it looks like they're always advancing. They're always looking for the upgrade and bringing in more and more things to where they're not static. You know, they don't get stagnant. They're not doing the same thing and just saying, we just stay the same. They're like me. I'm always upgrading. I'm always bringing. We just talked about an upgrade right now about creating the mobile salon exchange program where you're going over to other countries and working in mobile salons in other countries. Dude, imagine that. It's a logistical nightmare, but I think it's worth it. I think it's definitely worth it. And people from overseas, people from other countries coming here, and us, because it's not just us going there, it's them coming here. We would have to advise our people that, hey, this is an exchange barber. This is an exchange stylist. They used to work in Germany, or they were working in Australia and they're here doing hair. They want to experience the culture. They want to work and do hair here, because this is the best way to kind of absorb other nations and nationalities and all that. It would be a wondrous opportunity for us to build our world relationship, because people who deal with people are going to other lands and dealing with those people. Y'all know how important I tell y'all the barber and beauty industry is. We have our hands on the pulse of the nation at all times. At all times. I just ask yourself, who is the customers of barbers? The general public. Who are stylists, hairstylists, customers? Who are their customers? Everybody. The general public. Everybody. Everybody. You're talking regular people. You're talking teachers, students, lawyers, doctors, celebrities. Everybody has hair, has somebody doing their hair. Everybody. So that brings our importance level through the roof because we deal with everybody. So having the people who deal with the people, dealing with other people, taking care of and servicing other people and absorbing that nationality, absorbing that different land, and then taking it back to where they were. It's a whole, we probably wouldn't have as much nightmarish realities that we have right now with people going to war and shooting at folk and launching missiles and rockets and all that type of stuff if we just exchange cultures. Just go and visit, go and talk with people, go in and absorb other nationalities, eat other people's food, literally immerse yourself in other cultures so that people are not that foreign. People love to look at other places, other people, other things, and not understand or not know, and then they separate themselves from it. They completely cut themselves off from other cultures when it's not necessary. All you need to do is take a little effort to understand. It's a wild thing. We're gonna go deeper into this, especially in my seminars, because I've been talking about this and putting this on my logistics board, meaning go step by step of how we launching the program. This is definitely on my logistics board to execute. So I'm gonna be putting a lot of stuff together for it, for showcasing this industry and what we're doing. Right now, it's just, you know, a bunch of talk. It's just what we're thinking about, what we're working on. But once we start doing it, that's when the interest comes. When we're actually executing, that's when everybody, oh, what you got doing? Oh, man, what's going on? It kills me. It kills me. It literally is a knockout blow to me because I'm sitting up here listening to people, even like right now. I got buses that are rolling around right now. I got people that I network with that are in my network that are contracted with me that are rolling around. And I'll have people run up on me and I'll tell them what I do and what I have. And they'll be like, man, I never thought that. Oh, man, that is awesome. That's crazy. And I'm thinking like, we've been doing this for years. We've been talking about this for years. We literally been putting this thing in action, in place for years. But people are talking about it like we just created it yesterday, like it's never been existing, and this is a brand new thing that nobody has ever attempted or has never been a thing ever before in life. It's weird. It's very, very weird. And it's going to get even weirder when we actually start doing it on the mass, when we start doing it on a larger scale, when we start showcasing it to the people. They're going to come back and watch these videos. Watch what I tell you. They're going to come back and watch these videos and they're going to say, damn, he was doing this all along. We could have got in on this when he was doing it, when he was at this point. Yeah, pretty much. We could have got in, man. We could have been a part of this. We could have been a part of this when he was on the ground floor getting ready to launch. When he was literally putting things in order, putting things in place, we could have got in, put money in, and we could have been up there with that dude finna be a billionaire. We could have been right there with him if we'd have took the time to slow down, take a look, shut up, and take a look at what he got going on and jump in. Well, I do have people that have done that and that is doing that right now, but I cannot speak for everybody. And I've had people actually come up and say, like the thing that we have already, man, I've never seen that before. I've never heard of this. I've never even dreamed or thought that this was possible. And then they want to jump on, they want to get in because we haven't launched yet. We haven't went out there yet. So it's still, they're still, the opportunity is still, the door is still open. Okay. So that is a eye opener for me, because people actually see it and then they jump on it, they take advantage. But when people see it and then they wait, when people see it and then they still hold up, when people see it, they see the opportunity, right? They see the they see what I'm doing, they see the program I'm putting together, and they still, I'll lay back and just wait and see what happens. All right. Because I don't force anybody to do anything. You can pass up on this lottery ticket if you want to. That's you. I have zero qualms about anybody not taking advantage of opportunity when it knocks on their door. That's you. I don't do stupid stuff. I literally pride myself in observing opportunity when it knocks, because opportunity ain't nothing but blessings knocking. When God sees that you are pointed in the right direction, when you're headed in the sequence that He's already laid out for you, meaning your path, when you are observant of things and He sees the opportunity to put an opportunity in front of you, I'm all in. Opportunities are blessings in disguise. That's how He bless you. When He put an opportunity in front of you and you sit up there and say, "Nah, I'm good. I ain't really trying to, you know, do nothing either." Dude, the end all, the be all, the omega, the alpha and the omega, the man himself, the head honcho, the almighty, God himself is putting a blessing in front of you, the opportunity in front of your face, on your path. And you're literally saying, I ain't ready for it. All right, ain't got nothing to do with me. I'm telling you right now, every single time He puts an opportunity on my path, I jump on it, both feet head first. I jump on it because you definitely don't want to disrespect or offend the Almighty. If somebody bringing you something and they trying to bless you with something, and you tell them, I don't really want it. That could seriously cause a glitch in your next blessing. Imagine if you bring something and you trying to bless somebody and hook somebody up with something and they tell you, I don't want that. That's going to make you think, well, I ain't getting them shit else. I'm not even going to offer them nothing. I don't even play those type of games. When Almighty sends something to me, when God sends me anything, I'm on it. Hand it Him. I want it. Thank you. Appreciate it. Okay, thank you. Okay, they said 10 minutes. All right, y'all look early. Y'all must know I'll be going over. Let me check the other break too, because hold on guys, I'm supposed to check the other commercial. I just noticed it, my bad. I just noticed it myself. I was supposed to check the other link and go into another break, not a commercial break, a video break, where we go off to like a clip or sharing a screen, sharing space and all that, if our texts stay up. Yeah, I'm gonna check it. Okay, and I could put I thought I did. I didn't put the guest link. The guest link is right here. Yeah, that's the guest link right there for people to come on board. Yeah, I always have the guest link up. If I don't have the guest link up, guys, if y'all want to come on and be on the show, just let me know. Just put it in the chat. Say, hey, you doing a guest link today, and then I'll put the guest link up for you. Let me check this video cut out and see if it's working. and see if my my chat stays on the screen. So y'all bear with me. Yeah, y'all not gonna believe this, but I think they may even be listening to me where y'all see this full screen, it's now full screen. And you can see the words behind it. And it's free screen, y'all are on it. But yeah, Restream, y'all are on it. I'm gonna turn this one all the way down because I wanna hear the audio on it. Yeah, y'all are super on it. I was saying before that, remember, okay, there we go. Y'all remember I was saying that it cut the screen in half, and I hated that. I absolutely hated it. It looked so crappy. It looked super crappy. But now they allow you to do the full screen. Oh, there we go. Go ahead, Restream, you mother, some good job. Good job. That is so very, very awesome. I don't know why my screen on the middle right here, y'all might want to look at that, because I have it on the Restream. I have it on the 1, 2, 3, 4th option where the screen's supposed to be in the corner. So I don't know if y'all are doing anything with that or not, but I'm still not able to adjust the screen size. If I could adjust the screen size, that would be the piece de resistance. Okay, yeah. So yeah, if I could move these screens around and adjust these screen sizes, yeah, I we'd be killing it. Y'all be killing it then, because this is exactly what I'm talking about. I can see y'all probably is programming and working on it. So I definitely appreciate that. We just gotta get what's up, Deuce? What's happening? Dude, I see Deuce, I see Jerry. Oh, and Restream. I don't know what's going on with Instagram, but if we can get the Instagram links and their chats in here as well, that's a big thing. Because the Instagram chats doesn't show up. The X chats, which is formerly Twitter, I just call it Twitter X. The Twitter X chats don't show up. My bus chats doesn't show up. My website chats doesn't show up. Anywhere where you take if you don't know what I mean, anywhere where you take a RTMP link and you give it to a website, or you install that on a different server or a different web page or something like that, they have the ability to chat on that page, but we can't see it on our total lineup. So all of the different chats basically will not show up. And it's gonna be, to me, it's gonna be important because I actually read all my chats. And whether it's during the show or it's after the show, I go back and read all the chats. So I would love to be able to have it all in the one area where I don't have to go to 5-6 different websites and then go over reading all of those. If they're all under the Restream platform, y'all be killing it. y'all would be killing it. I'd love to get y'all as a sponsor so that I can promote outside of the show and promote on the buses and promote with, call me. There go my phone number right there. No, there go my phone number right there. Call me. So we can talk about some sponsorship and some advertising and promotion. And promotion. I'd love to get y'all out there because the service that y'all are building right now is phenomenal. Look at this. Man, guys, look. They got the full screen and the chat is right there. Y'all don't know. I've been dealing with this for a long time. I've been dealing with this for a couple of years now. And they're getting the chat to where it's just gangster. Look at my hand. And I can see it in the background. We didn't have that before. Unless I've lost my mind completely. I know for a fact we just didn't have that. And now we do, where other platforms may have it. I don't know. I don't care. This one works. And it works extremely well for what we're doing. And I haven't launched yet. I don't have, like, you see the chat right here? The chats for people who are out there who are actually actively promoting and getting people in, I'm not doing that yet. I will be, but I'm not doing it yet. Their chats will be going, you know, up and up and up and up and up. I have other chats and other platforms and they're kind of moving and whatnot, but I'm trying to get everything in position so that when I go, I got my moderators, I got my readers, I got my earpiece where they'll actually say, hey, there's somebody such and such asked for this and that and this and that. So I'll be able to completely, you know, have control and have a hold of the show and be able to indulge people and deal with them directly. Yeah, it's playing on the other side. They're talking to me now. It says, the other video still playing? Yes, the other video still playing, but it's not showing up. Okay, so restream. The other video was playing, but it wasn't showing up. I don't know what's going on with that, but you may want to take a look at that. And I'm going to turn it off now. And just see. Here's the video right here. This is the one that was, I'm so glad I looked at that because now I can see that it's all work. That video right there was playing. It was just playing and it's playing now, but it wasn't playing in the little box that's supposed to be in the corner. Okay. And we want to be able to move that box around and kind of make it bigger or smaller, like OBS. You can actually take the screen, move it to this corner or that corner or the other corner, and then resize it and stuff like that. It may be a big step, but hell, they're doing it. OBS is doing it. So I would think that it number one, is doable, obviously, but I would think that you guys may be able to do it. I don't know. I don't want to be presumptuous. I'm just saying. If somebody else is doing it, that means it's able to be done. And I would definitely put that on the shoulders of somebody who's actually doing it and have a platform and a service that is off. I have OBS and I have the whole platform that I can literally be streaming from OBS to Restream. But I'm like, dude, Restream, I should be able to just go right in Restream from anywhere. Because OBS, you have to actually be in studio and then stream to Restream, then Restream streams to everybody else. I'd rather just stream from Restream anywhere because I can take my phone and go anywhere and just stream and I'm good. I didn't see him. Hold on. They said Jacoby said something for me. Jacoby, I don't see a Jacoby on my list here. I see a Spearman. I see AJ Black Beauty. AJ Black is beautiful. I see AJ Black is beautiful. Double Fades. Sade Beauty Bar. And is that Deuce Manson? Is that Deuce Manson? I don't know how to pronounce it. DEUCEMASON. But that's all I have on this list. All right, guys, we're going to get up out of here. I'm so glad I did these tests. So now I can see what all is going on. My video is not playing either. It's filtering or it's buffering for some reason. I don't know why it would be buffering. Oh, no. You know what? That's one more thing. I'm sorry. It may be on my part to Restream. It may be on my part, but on my screen, when I'm looking at it, let me show you. I have multiple screens here. This is my setup. if they're watching. This is my setup. So I have, this is my security room, okay? And because my office is not done yet. But I have multiple screens set up. I just got a little light right there, and I got. But my office has a whole studio set up, so it'll be all the way right. But as you can see, my screen is showing black right here. Okay, see my screen. My screen is showing black, but on YouTube, it shows that it is playing. You see there? It shows that it is playing. It's playing on a loop. The video is playing on the loop, but on here, it's I can't see it. So I don't know if that's me on my system or if it's something that you guys can help me out with. So once again, this is doing that black screen, but over here on YouTube, you can see, matter of fact, let me make YouTube larger. I think I learned how to do that as well. Back right there. Boom, there we go. So that's the full screen. The other one was like a chat mode. So here's the screen. I can now see my screen, which is here, and then the video that's playing on the side. But over here, I just see my screen. I don't see the video playing. And I've messed up a couple of times because I thought that the video was not playing and it actually was. So if y'all can advise me on that or something, let me know. That's a pretty big issue as well. This is an automated camera. It has AI. I don't have anybody controlling it. It has AI in it. So it literally tracks my face or wherever. See that? It just tracks me to where I am and zoom in, zoom out and all that. So yeah, I'm super happy about the setup, guys. And look, right now, you can see my background where the text is, but I just learned that if you do full screen like that, it plays it. I can be behind the words right here. Man, that is freaking awesome. And then my AI will try to follow me. There we go. But yeah, that's what I wanted. Now, if we can get the videos to be playing, because it's supposed to be playing on the bottom here, but it's not. It doesn't stay full screen. So yeah, we got a ways to go, but we're working it. All right, let me get up out of here, guys. I thank you. They say you're out of time. All right, I appreciate it, guys. We'll be back tomorrow at 6 o'clock. So we'll be checking in and making sure this thing is working good. But I appreciate everybody for hanging in there with me and enduring me testing the system and all that good stuff. So I appreciate everybody for that. And I will see you all tomorrow. I am Ronnie Mac, owner of the Shops and Salons Network, the Hair Art Network, and the new Mobile Salon Network, bidding you guys peace and blessings. Please take care of yourself. And if you can, take care of someone else. If we all did that, we all would be taken care of. I looked over here. The camera is normally over here, but it's right here because I'm moving it around to show what's going on. And I got a mobile camera that I'll be going onto the buses. And we'll be going out on location and all that good stuff. Guys, we got some good stuff coming. Really good stuff coming. Okay, anyway. So thank you, everybody, for coming through. What did I say? I'm Ronnie Mac, owner of the Shops and Salon Network, the Hair Art Network, and the new Mobile Salon Network, bidding you guys peace and blessings. Please take care of yourself. And if you can, take care of someone else. If we all did that, we all will be taken care of. If you haven't signed up to the Mobile Salon Network, go to mobalon.com, M-O-B-A-L-O-N.com, and sign up. The application at the top of the page. On the right-hand side, click on it, fill it out, and submit it back in. If everything is good, someone will contact you and let you know what the next steps are. If you haven't donated, please donate. We have our own charity called Triple H Charity, stands for Haircuts for the Helpless and Homeless. You can go to www.hhhcharity.org to donate. We use your donations to build the buses that go out and do haircuts for the helpless and homeless. We also use your donations to pay the barbers and stylists to go out and do haircuts for the helpless and homeless. So it is a definitely awesome and worthwhile charity to donate to. And it's the only charity in the entire barber and beauty industry where you can actually see your donations at work, going out and doing haircuts for the helpless and homeless. Thanks, guys. I appreciate it. Oh, and that's for Haircuts for Heroes as well. So we also combine those two organizations to work under the same umbrella. I think I mentioned that before, but I don't have it on the website. I'm going to put it on there. Haircuts for Heroes, mobilehaircutsforheroes.com. That's just us going out and doing haircuts for police officers and and military vets, our military agents, Army, Navy, Air Force, Marines, our first responders, all that. We go out and get them taken care of using your guys' donations. Your donations pay for their hair services and whatnot to get them taken care of to where they can go out there and take care of us. All right, guys, that'll do it for us for today. I will be back tomorrow at 6 o'clock, so I'll see you all then. Everybody, please take care of yourself. Be careful out there. And remember our motto, respect yourself, because image is everything. Peace.